Live from Las Vegas, it's theCUBE, covering Knowledge 16. Brought to you by ServiceNow. Here are your hosts, Dave Vellante and Jeff Frick.
Welcome back to Knowledge 16, everybody. So each year we have a tradition on theCUBE at Knowledge, whatever, 16 this year, but other knowledges, where the penultimate segment, we bring in the winners of the hackathon contest. And so what happens is collaborators get together, they come up with an idea, they work on that idea, and they have about a 2.9% chance of winning. So we're very excited to have Sean Caron here. He's the principal solution architect at Linium, and Mike Brannon, who's a senior program manager at National Gypsum, a customer of Linium. Gentlemen, welcome to theCUBE and congratulations on your victory.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So, the app is happiness as a service, right?
That's correct,
so how did that come about? Tell us the story.
So, the United Network for Organ Sharing, or UNOS, is a customer of ours. And they're really, really great people. And one of the things that you notice when you go to their building is they have a lot of information posted all around, signs and even memorial walls, about their donors and their recipients. And you get the sense really quickly that kids who are in need of an organ transplant, they're sick kids. They're really, kind of in dire straits. So we thought it'd be kind of neat to build an innovative app that would allow them to do almost a make-a-wish type of a scenario. Come in and say, hey, I'd like to swim with the dolphins or go to a baseball game or go to Disneyland. And then match them up with donors who are willing to fund that and build a process whereby we could enable their smiles. Right? Put a smile on a sick kid. So that was the basic theory behind the app.
That's awesome. And Mike, how did you get involved in the team? Take us through that.
We're working with Linium now on our deployment. We're not live yet. We're in sprint 3 of release 1, going live the second week of June. They reached out and said, hey, we've got this hackathon role to come in, be a project manager, help us with Scrum, which was something we're doing on our project. So I threw my hat in the ring and came to participate with the guys. It's been a fun ride.
And what's the, Sean, what are the rules of engagement? You can get together a little bit beforehand and brainstorm, right? So describe
right.
that process.
Yeah, we basically sat together probably 4 or 5 times before we got here, talked about what were the function points we wanted to have in the application. We created a picture of what we wanted the app to look like. It's on Mike's shirt right there.
That's the outcome.
That's the outcome.
The outcome back. Beautiful.
That's it. Yeah,
awesome.
That's it exactly. If you go to the YouTube pages that ServiceNow has put up, you can actually see it, see me demoing it. And we put that together. We thought about how are we going to make sure that we hit all the function points we want to. That's really where we got Mike involved, because in a program manager role, he keeps us on point to say, hey, we spent maybe too much time on this one. Maybe we consider not including that function point. We want to make sure we got everything built. We had one thing we tried to do we didn't have time to complete, right? But we knew that because we kept track of it in ServiceNow. So,
and the rules are you can't start coding until the clock goes?
The only thing you can bring in is images, right? So we had these little pictures that you see on Mike's shirt ready to go in a file, and that's the only thing you can bring to the table. Everything else, we had in our head what the tables were going to look like and how they would relate to each other and how the function points should use those tables, but none of that came in. We built all that on site.
And how large was the team?
We had six folks for 8 hours, so yeah.
So we did a sprint per hour,
right?
And got together, kept focused, and kept after it. Started at 4 o'clock, had to finish by midnight. They gave us some time after they gave out the golden tickets to make a few adjustments so that we could have a little bit better performance for the demos. But it was a lot of fun.
So, okay, and your role was to sort of monitor the productivity and the velocity of each
exactly.
of those sprints
yep.
and try to...
I was also loading data. Someone had to do data
doing
entry.
Doing the grunt work.
somebody's got to
awesome.
Do it.
Well, and testing, right? And
yep.
yeah, he had his hands in almost every piece of it.
Yeah.
No doubt. But that's, we found, to keep a project with this many different things that we wanted to make happen on track. ServiceNow's SDLC is a great tool to do that in the real world. That's what Mike does for his day job. So it was a perfect opportunity. We also brought in some folks from Horizon Blue Cross Blue Shield, a customer of ours. So they had a developer here, a guy we've been working with for years. So he wrote a lot of code for us. We had a guy from Honda who unfortunately had to back out because he couldn't come to K16, but he helped us with a lot of the initial design and put a lot of those pieces together.
So what was the makeup of the coders? You know, you had to draft a team, you need a wide receiver, you need a quarterback,
right,
and center. What the profile of the team look like?
So project manager, that was Mike. We had a couple people who were writing code pretty extensively, just, you know, kind of ServiceNow app code, standard kind of things. We had one person doing integrations, and it was one person who was responsible for the look and feel, the CMS work in ServiceNow. Of course, in the future, we'll use Service Portal to do that in Helsinki, but you know, for this app, we stuck with what we knew, which is the older style CMS.
So what kind of integrations do you do in such a short period of time? I mean, yeah. I can see how you build the functionality in the front and the look and feel, but what are you integrating to?
So we had a map integrated to Bing Maps, and so you could go in and say, show me a kid near me that I'm interested in supporting.
Right.
So map, push pins, click a push pin. There was an integration that brought up their picture and allowed you to click a button to connect to PayPal and make a donation, as an example.
Yeah, those are pretty much the key integrations that we had in place. Yeah.
And it looks beautiful. I mean, at least on your shirt, I'm sure it looks even better on my mobile.
We're very lucky to have a really talented graphic designer who works with us, who helped us pick the images. And you know, she has a great eye for things that really pop
really,
on the screen.
Really, the color scheme, I mean, it's great.
Yeah.
So what's next? I mean, what happens now?
Well, so a couple different things are going on. As we said, we're donating the application as it is to the folks at UNOS. And actually, if you watch our demo video, we had three of the folks who were here at K16 from UNOS in the demo video with us. So they'll be grabbing this application. The other thing we decided to do, we thought it would be kind of a neat thing to do as a team, is to donate the money winnings for the first kid. So we're going to stand the thing up, find some kids, and then we're going to donate the money winnings that we had to allow those kids to start on whatever their wish is going to be.
Fantastic.
Then just, I just think it's such an interesting concept where they bring together this kind of disparate group of people. I mean, you kind of organize yourself ahead of time, which sometimes we've talked to hackathon winners that don't know each other from Adam.
That's
you
right.
Know? Yep. But just kind of the experience of, you know, 4 o'clock, clock starts, you got drones flying overhead, your head's down, you got sprint after sprint after sprint.
Yep.
Just kind of the team building and what it does for you. And obviously you have not only a cool app, but a really meaningful app to kind of sit and work together on a project like this, kind of removed from your day job and email. Of course, we don't do email at ServiceNow. But, you know, the other things that kind of distract you, to have this kind of nice focus in on such a cool project.
Yeah, I think a lot of folks who are serious about writing code have that ability to kind of turn off the world, take a function point, go get it, right? I think that's a thing that a lot of developers have, and we kind of all had that. Not that we didn't have some fun. I mean, there were some video games, kind of old-timey video games to play. There were some old-fashioned pinball machines, which I had for a little while. They kept us really well supplied with food. They even had a keg for a while, so that was kind of neat. Pizza and, you know, all the stuff coders need to
Were you
successful.
Peeking at the other guys?
There were so many different things. If you look at the 9 golden ticket winners, the stuff people were doing were so different. You know, there was one team had a button you could push that would automatically create an incident in ServiceNow. It's kind of cool. You know, there were people who use Service Portal to, you know, guide your life in terms of, am I getting enough exercise and enough nutrition? Just all different things that people had ideas to build. And those are just the ones with the golden tickets. You know, there were 25 other teams that were building things as
well. You put that many creative people in a room that are talented, and what an honor to win. I mean, really, you must have been so stoked.
Yeah, it sure is. Yeah, I thought we had a good shot in the innovative category. There were about, I think, maybe 9 teams that competed in that. So, you know, we thought we had a good shot. We had a great story, right? I mean, half this is just having a great story to tell.
Yep.
And the folks at UNOS were so happy to have us building something for them. So that was a big help.
How does that get announced? What's that experience
they
like?
They put it out for voting.
Right.
And, of course, you know, you have to do a little publicity to up your vote count.
Campaigning?
Sean was our Donald Trump. But we got out there and sort of campaigned a bit and got some votes rolling in. It was a surprise announcement lunchtime today, which was kind of cool. You knew you were in the running, but you didn't know who won. And we were very surprised to be both the category and the grand prize winners. And as a rookie, this is my first knowledge. I felt really privileged to be a part of all this. And, you know, it can only go up from here.
But, well, I was saying, hopefully it only goes
that
up
or
from
you can never come back again. I don't know. One of the two.
That's right.
Well, gentlemen, congratulations on such great work. And the cause is fantastic. And really a pleasure having you on the Cube. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, thank you very much. It's a great experience.
Absolutely.
All right. Keep it right there, everybody. We'll be back to wrap Knowledge 16 from the Cube right after this brief word.
This is a tale of two